Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the sixth tutorial of STAAD.Pro. In this tutorial, we are going to learn a very interesting command, that is Translation Repeat. Using Translation Repeat command is a quick process to make copies of nodes and beams. As we don't need this grid, then we close this window. First, we will create a single node at origin and I am giving here 0, then press enter. Then I have gotten a point at the origin. Now I will apply translation repeat on this point. Before doing that, I have to select this node. To select, I have to click on my workspace, then go to selection toolbar. Here there is node cursor, I'm clicking on it and then click on this node, then the node is selected. To get translation repeat, I have to go here, there is translation repeat icon, or I can go to geometry option and here there is translation repeat. I am clicking on this option, then we got a small window, and let's move this window a little bit this side. In this plan, I am going to copy this node in x direction, and there are some spacings given here, 3.3 meter, 2.3 meter, and 4.3 meter. So now this point is my origin, and I will create this 3 point by translation repeat. As I want those 3 points in x direction, then I am clicking on x, and here there are 3 steps. This is first step, this is second step, and this is third step. So I am going to this option, number of steps, I am giving here 3. If your spacings are same, then you can input here default step spacing, but my spacings are not same, so I have to input here. Here spacing are 3.3, 2.3 and 4.3. So I am inputting the spacings here. Then we are done and I am clicking on OK. As I click OK, in my workspace we have gotten 3 points as we wanted. Now let's create these 2 points in Z direction, and here number of steps is 2, and first spacing is 5.3 and the second spacing is 4.3. To do that, first of all I have to select this node, and it is already selected, so I have to go here for translation repeat. I am clicking on this icon. As I want these points in Z direction, so I have to click in Z option. Then I have to give number of steps as 2, and I will input here spacing. First spacing is 5.3 and second spacing is 4.3. This time I want to get beams also, so I have to link those nodes, and I have to use this option, link steps. So I am clicking on this box and then I click OK, and similarly we have gotten these 2 points, and they are not only nodes, they are beams also, they are linked. If you want to join these nodes and create beams, then you have to use add beam option, but now I don't want to use add beam option. Now we will learn something new. To do this, I have to go to geometry option. Then there is a option, connect beams along x, y and z axis, but these are blank because we didn't select those nodes yet. So I have to press escape to come out from this window. Then I will select these nodes first. I have selected those nodes by a window, but there is a node that should be selected also, so I press Ctrl, then click on this node, then that node also being selected. Then I will go to geometry option, then come to here, connect beam along, and these nodes are along x axis, so I am clicking on x axis option. Then I click OK. Then those nodes are linked and we have got 3 beams. Now let's click on this table anywhere, then the nodes will not be selected anymore. Now I want to create this point and this point with the help of translation repeat, and we will use this node. Here number of steps is 2, and the first spacing is 5.3 and the second spacing is 3.3. but to do that, I have to select the node first. I'm clicking on this node, then I go there and clicking on this icon. Now I have to give number of steps. Here it is 2, and first spacing was 5.3 and the second spacing was 3.3. and as we want those points along Z direction, so I am clicking on Z option, and I want those nodes linked up, so I am clicking on link option, then I am clicking on OK. This time I will apply this translation repeat on beams, not on nodes. So I have to select these 2 beams first, then I will apply translation repeat on those beams, and I will get these 2 beams. So let's first select these 2 beams, but now our cursor is node cursor. I have to make it beam cursor, so I will go there and I will click here, and our cursor is beam cursor now. Then I will select this beam, and press Ctrl and select this beam also. Then I have to go in this option, click there. In this time there is only one steps, that is 4.3 meter spacing, and that is along X axis. So here number of spacing is on, and I am clicking on X option, and I will give the spacing as 4.3, and as they are linked up, so I have to click on link option. I am clicking on link steps, then I click OK. Now I have to get these two points. To get that, I will apply translation repeat on this point, and the first spacing will be 3.3, and this spacing is 5.3 minus 3.3, that is 2. But to do that, I have to select this node first. But now our cursor is beam cursor. First we click on our workspace, then we go to here, there is node cursor, and now I click on this node, then that node is being selected. And now I will go here and click on this icon, then I will give the number of step as 2, and this is along Z axis, so I'm clicking on this Z option, and first spacing is 3.3 and the second spacing is 2, and I want those nodes linked, so I'm clicking on link steps, then I'm clicking OK. Now I have to join these two nodes, and I will use add beam option. To get add beam option, I will go there. Here there is add beam option. I'm clicking on this icon, then I'm clicking on this node and this node. Then I press escape to come out from add beams command, and this time I have to create this node, and I will use translation repeat for this node. And here there is only one step, and the spacing is 5.6. To do that, I have to select this node first, but now our cursor is beam cursor, so I have to go there and click on this icon, then I will click on this node, then I will go here for translation repeat. Number of steps is 1 and the spacing is 5.6, and I want those two nodes linked, so I'm clicking on this box and clicking OK. Now I have to join these two nodes. For that, I will select these two nodes, then I will go to geometry option, and I will connect these beams along Z axis, then I will click OK, and these two nodes have been joined, and we will get another beam. Let's click on this workspace. As there is no node and this is not any kind of beam, so I'm not going to create this one. So I have gotten our plan with the help of translation repeat. This time I am going to make copy of this total structure in y direction. My number of floors will be 4, and the spacing of each floor will be 4.3 meter. So first of all, I have to click the total structure, but as it is now node cursor, so only nodes have been selected. Let's make it beam cursor, then select all these beams, then go to translation repeat. This time I am going to make copy of this structure on y direction, so I am clicking on this y, and here the number of steps will be 4. I'm giving here 4, and this time I have a same spacing, so I will give the default step spacing as 4.3, and I will link these steps, so I'm clicking on this box, then clicking on OK. See how easily we got our structure within a few minutes. If I view it from positive Z, then we will get our elevation, and here is 4 floors, each floor is 4.3 meter. If we view it from positive Y, then we will get the plan of whole structure. So I have to go there, and I will click this icon, then I will get the plan of my building. There are some limitation of translation repeat, and that is you will get only 99 steps. If I input here 98, then I click on this arrow, then again click, then see it is not going up. So maximum number of steps is 99 here, and it is the limitation of translation repeat, and I think it will not make any trouble for you, because 99 steps is enough. But you have to know that you will get maximum 99 steps by translation repeat. And there are some other options like open base. It finds the lowest point of the structure and does not link along that direction. If you don't want to link the bottom points of a structure, then you will check that box. And here generation flux. If you want to copy those nodes or beams with geometry or property or other things that they are assigned on that beams and nodes, then you can choose these options. If you want to copy geometry only, then you will click on this option. And if you want to copy geometry and property, then you will choose this option. And if you want to copy all things that they are carrying, setting, then you will choose this all option. So this is all for today, and this is all for translation repeat. I hope you have understood everything as I said very clearly. But further, if you have any kind of problems or if you face any troubles, then please comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, keep practicing. Happy learning. See you in the next video.